sound, noise and music. Now that you know the basics of what sound is, can you say what the difference is between noise and music? They are both sounds. Music is sound that is pleasant to the ear, melodious and enjoyable. All other sounds are noise. So the sound of the drill, all students in a classroom speaking together, the horns of buses and trucks are all noise. All the noise around you at high volume causes noise pollution. During festivals, we have loud music played and firecrackers which add to the noise pollution. Our air conditioners, televisions, kitchen appliances add to the noise we are exposed to all the time too. Constantly being in noise pollution can lead to high blood pressure, lack of sleep, nervous disorders and other problems in addition to hearing loss. There are rules about how much sound is allowed in many residential areas and even more restrictions near schools and hospitals. However, citizens have to be aware and willing to follow the rules to make the world around us a better place. How the ears hear the sound? You know that sound is made from the mechanism inside your throat. But how do we hear sound? With our ears. The ears collect sound, process them and send them to brain. Is that all the ears do? No, they also help you to keep your balance. The ear has three sections. The outer ear that we can see, the middle ear and the inner ear. The outer ear is called the pinna. It has a shape that helps to catch sound waves and direct them into the ear. The ear canal, which is where the wax collects, is also a part of the outer ear. The ear wax helps to stop dirt from going into the ear. So remember, ear wax isn't gross, it's really useful. From the outer ear, the sound waves go to the middle ear. The middle ear has to now convert the waves into vibrations and send them into the inner ear. How does it do that? With the help of the eardrum. The eardrum is actually like a drum. It's a thin piece of skin that is stretched tight, just like we have on drums. When the sound waves hit the eardrum, the skin vibrates. There are three very tiny and delicate bones behind the skin of the eardrum. These are called ossicles. When the drum vibrates, these ossicles move. That sends the sound into the inner ear. In the inner ear is a small curved tube called the cochlea. It is filled with liquid. When the tiny ossicles vibrate, the liquid inside the cochlea moves like a wave. That moves the tiny hairs inside the cochlea. When that happens, they create electric signals that the nerves carry to the brain. The brain gets these signals and puts them together and understands what you have heard. So, you know that you are listening to your favorite song. I also told you that the ear helps to keep your balance. There are three loops above the cochlea filled with liquid and hairs. When you move your head, these hairs move because of the liquid and send messages to your brain about the position of your head. Then, the brain sends messages to other muscles to help to keep your balance. Isn't it amazing how the body works? As you can see, there are so many different things that need to happen properly one after another so that you can hear properly. If anything in the chain isn't working, you will have a hearing problem. Some people have a problem because the outer ear isn't sending the sound properly to the middle ear. Usually, this can be treated with medicines. You can even have a problem in the part of the brain that understands the sounds. That type of hearing loss is very difficult to treat. There are many other problems that can happen too, such as a problem with the fluid in the middle ear, or an ear infection, or a head injury, or listening to very loud music, or constant exposure to loud sounds. Now that you know basic stuff about the ears, you know that you should not do anything that would damage all the delicate parts inside. Don't put objects into your ears, not even cotton swabs. You can damage the eardrum, and once that is damaged, you've lost your hearing. You really can't fix it. If you think you have a hearing problem, talk to your family and meet a doctor. They can check your ears and even run some tests on your hearing. Just like we have glasses to see better, we have hearing aids that help to make sounds louder before they are sent into the ear, so we can hear better. Some kids have implants in their cochlea. Those can take up the job of the tiny hair cells that turn sound into electric signals to send to the brain. People with hearing loss may need special techniques to communicate, such as sign language, closed captioning, lip reading, and even speech-to-text converters. What did we just learn? Unpleasant sounds are called noise. Noise pollution may cause health problems in human beings. Plantation on the roadside and elsewhere can reduce noise pollution.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.